stepping on this ice surface after all these years is still intimidating for them. The skating first makes it even more so.
But they are veterans in handling the pressure. Barbara now 32 years old. Paul is 35.
Next year, they'll be celebrating their 20th anniversary together. And they open with one of pair skating's most difficult tricks, split triple twist. Little tight on the landing. I said the deciding factor could be this road triple sow cow. Here it is.
Barbara Underhill and Paul Martini and Sandra not their greatest.
The takeoff is solid, as usual. Nice and tight in the air, and she's just slow to check that free leg out, and you can see she over-rotates the jump.
9.7. 9.7. 9.7.
There are 9. Two more pairs 8. To skate. The 9. Judges 9. Obviously 7. Have to leave room and take 9. Into account
7.
The air.
And 9.7. So by Underhill and Martini standards, mediocre scores, a total 48.5. St. Petersburg, Russia. But it was another 10 years before they were paired up, relatively late in their careers. Married for a while, but now divorced. And they say they get along much better these days.
An extremely strong pair, Tom. Their weakness, however, is Elena's nerves when they compete. She told me before the competition they were taking out their side-by-side double axles instead to do these double flips. She wanted to enjoy this performance, she said, for a change.
Making the program less difficult, though, does that compromise their chances of winning?
If they land this jump, no.
And they didn't. Was that Elena's nerves again, perhaps?
Yes. When she performs in exhibition, she is always flawless. And then in competition, she says she just starts to think too much.
Would you tell me that you love me?
Petrov.
Betsky and Petrov.
The woman to see where the error was made. But watch Dennis and his lack of flow. She has great height, but not time enough to check out her free.
Joined by their coach, Tamara Moskvina.
9.8.
Pretty good start.
9.8.
These reflect the speed and the strength of the performance.
And you see they're delighted with those marks.
9.8.
A couple of
9.9.
9.6, which will be the final technical program in the pairs competition. Radka Kovarakova and Renee Novotny from the Czech Republic. In their first season as professional skaters, having turned pro after their win at the 1995 World Amateur Championships.
It's been an overwhelming season for them. They've had difficulties competing as professionals, not really understanding what the judges expect or what the audience expects. It's a learning experience the first year out.
Skating to Tchaikovsky's Romeo and Juliet.
Choreographed by Marina Klimova and Sergei Ponomarenko.
We'll see them later in the dance competition.
Opening with side-by-side triple toe jumps. Very nice, and the only side-by-side triple toes we will see this evening. And now for their throw, the throw triple toe loop. Gorgeous. And with that opening, those two elements, that will set them very clearly in the lead. And a triple twist to top it off.
They are engaged to be married despite a 12-year age difference. She's 20, he's 32.
And then this throw triple toe jump. Now this is the element, a similar element to what the other pairs missed. Gorgeous. perfect. That now landing position.
Here's some near perfect scores, 9.9.
9.9. 10.
And one perfect 10.
9.9 and 9.9.
And the total score, 49.5. Of all time. Chris married the former world champion Jill Trenery, who tells me they plan to start a family soon. Jane, 38, Chris, 37. Guess what they're skating to? Still crazy after all these years.
They've been together 20 years. In this arena, you push yourself to explore new positions. And I think what happened in 94 is they were trying to play by the book, by the International Skating Union book, which they never did before, and it didn't work for them that time, and now they're...
10.
Well, the judges loved it, too.
9.9.
Can you imagine always skating under the pressure of being the best 10. Of all time? You almost... have to have 10s to satisfy everyone. And the 9.8 draws a real reaction from the crowd.
9.9.
49.8 puts them in first place.
And what you won't see in an international skating union competition are props, and certainly not ropes. Another Piazzolla tango.
You have to be extremely trusting of your partner. I mean, think if you were having an off night and she had a rope around your neck.
Well, partner.
Is that a rope I see you have in your purse?
And Sergey Ponomarenko.
A wonderful and completely different interpretation to a Piazzolla tango.
Different it was, and who would appreciate innovation better than that pair? Torvalin.
9.9.
Good start.
9.8. 9.
9.8. 10.
Now there's a perfect 10, but not as many as Torvald Lundin, of course.
9.8 and 9.7.
49.2 the total, and that puts them in second place behind Torvald and Dean. Coming up, Christy Yamaguchi and the ladies' competition. Although they now live and train in Lake Placid, New York, a typical Russian ice dancing performance.
9.8.
Consistent marks from the judges.
9.9.
And pretty good, but not good enough to win. 49.2.
49.2.
Their rivalry goes all the way back to 1984.
Marina and Sergei will skate the story of Romeo and Juliet to the score of Tchaikovsky.
Thank you.
Romeo and Juliet, as skated by the Russian husband and wife team, Marina Klimova and Sergei Ponomarenko.
In 1984, they were the Olympic bronze medalists in
9.9.
Excellent marks.
10.
Well, the pressure's on.
10. 9.8.
That will be eliminated, 10. Though, that 9.8. And near a perfect mark, 49.9 out of a possible 50 for Klimova and Ponomarenko, regarded as the best ice dancers ever. Decades on the ice together and still at the top of their game, Jane Torval and Christopher Dean.
Just great. Whenever I watch them skate, I sit back and wish I had thought of that.
Many in the crowd standing. This is a record crowd, over 18,000, one of the largest crowds to ever see skating anywhere.
They keep coming up with new ideas, new ways of moving. I'm always captivated. It's fantastic.
Jane Torval and Christopher Dean.
But they need
two more bestsellers become.
Could be close.
10.
Well, they begin with two perfect marks.
10. 9.7.
Well, Colin Benson always manages to get on camera at least once in an event.
10.
49.9. To give them the championship. Torval and Dean.